Hello, good morning students. Once again I welcome you all in Communication Skills B first year lecture. Today we are going to discuss about types of communication. Earlier we understood about the process of communication, and today's lecture we are going to discuss about types of communication. There are two types of communications. One is verbal and second one is non-verbal. In this particular slide, we are going to discuss about how these particular types are working. The first one is verbal and second one is non-verbal. With this picture you are getting, see, the verbal communication is a communication through spoken or written words. Verbal communication is made by spoken words through face-to-face or through electrical device, such as phone, teleconferencing, etc. To understand this, we were having explanation about it. In other words, the communication in which the sender uses words to transmit the message to the receiver is called verbal communication, that we do generally in general communication. It means communicating with the words written or spoken. Verbal communication consists of speaking, listening, writing and reading. These are the four most components of communication. Now we are going to get some characteristics of effective verbal communication. We all speak, we are human, we are having tendency to communicate with each other through languages, and now we try to understand the characteristics of effective verbal communication. Let's see. Consider the objective, be sincere, use simple language, use familiar words, be brief and precise, assume nothing, use polite words and tone, say something interesting and pleasing, more personal and informal. If you read these points on this particular slide, you would be getting that whenever we are having a communication, our language should be simple. We should use familiar words that we use earlier. If you are going to use first time new word, that will be difficult for you to pronounce it. So make sure you should be very sincere about communication. Your language should be simple. You should use familiar words. And most importantly, that I would like to add in this particular slide, that is, assume nothing. You should not assume when you are having conversation with anyone. Use polite words, always use polite words. These are remaining. Make immediate impact, provide opportunity for interaction and feedback. It is fastest and less expensive and be quickly forgotten. There is no legal evidence of oral communication. And the last point, impact may be short-lived. So you also consider these points also, because these are the characteristics of effective verbal communication. Next slide. Types of verbal communication. The first part we are going to discuss, that is oral communication. Oral communication that we all do, like spoken words, face-to-face conversation, telephonic conversation. In written communication, that we generally draft or letters, reports, projects, documents, social media, email, SMS, that all comes in written communication. In oral communication, spoken words are used. It includes face-to-face conversations, speech, telephonic conversation, video, radio, television, voice over internet, etc. In oral communication, communication is influenced by pitch, volume, speed, and clarity of speaking. This we have to remember whenever we are having conversation, and whatever knowledge you are having, if you show through proper presentation and communication, it will be a greater height for your success. In written communication is important for school, work, and everyday activities. In the workplace, written communication skills are needed for writing emails, office memos, reports, business letters, etc. Some people have difficulty putting their thoughts into words just because they are not having command over the language, not about spoken but written also. So you remember, you need to extend your vocabulary. Just read one word at a day and you will have a complete 365 word list in 1 year. Other people find it easier to communicate by using written communication skills. Written communication skills can be improved through practice. Reading newspapers and books may help improve writing skills. So I suggest all my dear students, so please start reading newspapers. Even you are reading the books also, but try to understand the meaning of the particular word so that it will be easy for you to understand. So developing habit of reading, that is one of the greatest skills that anyone should develop. In non-verbal communication, that is the second type of communication, non-verbal personal communication may be defined as the communication between the sender and the receiver when both physically present at a place, use the means other than language or spoken word to convey their feelings and thoughts. See, sometimes it happens, if you are not getting the words, if you are not having the particular language information, we try to convey others through gestures, through body language. These are the pictures already display on this particular slide. You can see, if I have to say four, I will use like this. If I don't have a word to say, like that only. If I have to say it is good, I will do like this only. This is one kind of process to convey message through non-verbal communication. These are all things that you can see, that all pictures you can see, these are the signs of non-verbal communication. So we need to remember it. In non-verbal communication, the communication that takes place between sender and the receiver with the use of sign or body language. As I said, you need to show the sign or body language to convey your message to others if you don't know about the language. This communication can be through facial expression, eye contact, smile and body language. It doesn't mean you don't know language. Even you know the language, but somebody is not trying to understand, somebody is not getting your words spoken by you. So you can show through facial expression. Suppose you are getting angry, you are having expression. Suppose you want to make eye contact with, that time also you can show through your eyes, through your smile, through your body language. In above all these contents, body language is very common. Body language shows everything. It is the integral part of non-verbal communication. Types of non-verbal communication we'll discuss now. See, these are the different factors shows in this particular body language component, that is appearance, that is facial expressions, that is facial expressions, that is smile, that is eye contact, that may be voice, that may be energy, that may be space, that may be time. Paralanguage, sign language, you can even show through signs, through symbols, through signals, through postures and gestures. Even you can show through, show means you can convey your message through your attire. Particular dress you wear, then easily that message will go to the next person who is looking at you, that he is having a police attire, that means he's a police officer. Getting me? Like that. Appearance. It is very important factor, as what a person wears conveys a message about their personality. There are clothes that are appropriate for various types of situation. As I said, as I given the example for a police inspector or police attire, the same you can see if this boy has wear the t-shirt and or cap that shows he is someone is a sports person, or he is a it's just a boy is wearing a kind of attire. And see, left hand picture, if you see, these are the office dress for both male and female, and most of the time we wear such kind of attire at the time of interview. During an interview, A well-dressed person will look more presentable than the person who is shabbily dressed. So, that is also a part of non-verbal communication. Facial expressions, which is very, very essential. The human face is extremely expressive, able to express countless emotions without saying a word. And unlike some forms of non-verbal communication, facial expressions are universal. The facial expressions for happiness, sadness, anger, surprise, fear, and disgust are the same across cultures. Through these slides you can understand these are the different facial expressions you can see in this slide. And this is also a one common and integral part of facial expression, that plays a very important role in non-verbal communication. The human face is extremely expressive, that we all know, that is able to express countless emotions without saying a word. And unlike some forms of non-verbal communication, facial expressions are universal. This is the biggest content in non-verbal communication. Smile. We all do smile. See what happened? It's a part of non-verbal communication. It's a part of facial expression. The most strong body language signal to influence our first impression is the smile. Whenever you want to communicate without saying a word, you want to convey your message, just have a smile. If you have a smile that gives a positive impression on others, you can communicate before communication. Even you can convey your message by throwing a smile to the person. So that is a part of nonverbal communication. It is the most recognized signal everywhere. This is the most recognized signal everywhere, not only for country, not only for a particular state. If wherever you go on this particular globe, you are having this smiling kind of face, you are conveying the message easily, because it is the thing that can be identified by any person of the globe. To remember this one, it doesn't mean I don't know the French language and I don't know Chinese, but I'm having the smile, that kind of content, you can say content, for this non-verbal communication. So automatically a kind of positive atmosphere create for you, and you can start your communication after it. Smiling is an international language. As I said, it is an international language. Eye contact, when we do eye contact, it shows our confidence. It shows that something you want to convey to others with the help of your eye contact. That means you are having something that you want to say, that is truth, that is having truth in that particular content, and you are positive about it and you are confident about it. Eye contact is an important way of interpersonal communication. It helps to control the flow of communication. We'll get more on this and eye contacts. Let's see, picture shows everything. I'm conveying through slide, that means I'm trying to convey through non-verbal communication also to all of you. So remember that this particular slide, if I don't speak, even that you can read, you can get those ideas, you can see these pictures and you can understand what I want to convey. In eye contact is a form of non-verbal communication and is thought to have a large influence on social behavior. It is believed to show personal involvement and create intimate bonds. Mutual gaze narrows the physical gap between humans. You can read one's mind by looking at eyes. You can easily understand what is going on that particular person's mind by looking at his eye. Voice, very important factor. Vocalic, non-verbal aspects of our voice, like pitch, how high or low a speaker voice is, rate, how fast the person speaks, you can identify, volume, how loudly the person speaks. Expectations are that your vocalic should be adopted based on the situation. Energy, this is one of the strongest factor used in non-verbal communication, that is energy. An energetic person maintains the certain level of enthusiasm in work, and it is reflected in the style, and it is usually infectious and make listeners feel enthusiastic. Space. The amount of space between two people is also a form of non-verbal communication and often depends on the degree of intimacy or comfort between them. People who stand too close when speaking to you, particularly if you do not know them well, can make you feel uncomfortable. Space or the lack of it can convey either affection or aggression. So space is also very much essential. Example of space that we should discuss here. Spatial zones, distance beyond 12 feet in public distance, giving a speech or lecture to a group of people, 4 feet to 12 feet for social distance. Nowadays social distance is very much essential, we all know. Conversation with a stranger, business meeting, ranges from 18 inches to 4 feet personal distance. Conversation with friend and ranges out to about 18 inches, that is intimate distance, sitting with the loved one or nursing an infant. This is a criteria based already for having conversation. Now the next point that we need to discuss in this lecture, non-verbal communication. Time, chronomics, even we say chronology, study of how we use time to communication. Time is money in business environment. Send signals indicating importance of time to people. Time management is important in business. Communication should be rightly timed to be effective. See, in about these 5 points, one thing that I would like to give you, that you, if you really want to build your communication effectively, your communication should be rightly timed and it should be effective. Study of how we use time to communication, and time is money in business environment. These two factors also essential for all of you. That's why I can say, because time is a factor that having that plays very important role. And if you manage the time properly for even communication also, that can be effective. If you use a number of words at a time and you are trying to convey the message by using different words, what will happen, it will be very, very difficult for you. You cannot communicate properly if you are using a number of words. Use a proper time, use effective words, and your communication will be effective. Paralanguage, the vocal but non-verbal dimension of speech. It has to do with the manner in which you say something rather than what you say. Like rate, speed of which you speak. If you speak too much fast, what will happen? You cannot communicate properly, because you may have a great vocabulary, you may have a different words that others don't. But what will happen if your speed is too fast? You cannot communicate properly, and others, those are listeners to you, would not understood anything. Second point, volume, loudness or quietness of vocal speech. Pitch, the highness or lowness of vocal tone. People perception and persuasion is also there. In paralanguage, the term paralanguage is a combination of two words. You should know what is paralanguage. It may be new word for you, but I'm trying to explain here also with the particular definition of Professor Barker and Gott. First of all, we'll try to understand how this word comes. The term paralanguage is combination of two words. Para means like, and language means mode of communication. Thus, paralanguage literally means like language. In the other words of Professor Barker and God, a language alongside of language and includes vocal characteristics such as pitch, range, resonance, tempo and quality, and various vocal sounds such as grunts, groans and clearing the throat. Now, if you all are watching news in our news channel, these are our vocal, but one also news comes in different channels. If you might have seen, that is a sign news, sign language news, with through their particular one anchor is there, and she is elaborating with the help of different gestures through her hand. Most of the time we might have seen through her facial expression also. That is called a sign language. This is also a part of non-verbal communication. She is not uttering a word, but she is explaining through her symbols, her facial expression and all this. So let's know more about sign language. A sign is a mark traced on a surface or an object with a view to indicate a particular meaning. A sign may give out an information, instruction or warning. It may also be gesture, a movement or sound to convey something specific. Example, priests and elders convey their blessing by placing their hands on the heads of the people moving to them. You might have seen in temples and some other areas are the priests are putting their hands on the people, they are blessing them. This is a sign of blessing. Example 2, we'll try to understand more on that. Finger on the lips to suggest keep quiet or keep silent. When we are giving such kind of expressions, or when we are putting the particular finger on the lips, that means we want to convey this, that the particular people should keep silent. So these are the sign language that you are getting hope. Such signs are sometimes group specific and are accepted as a matter of conversation. A sign may also relate to written work conventionally used to convey a specific meaning. Such signs may be general, as in case of road and traffic signs, or subject specific signs specific to a profession like mathematics, algebra, etc. So you all should understood the sign, what is sign language and how sign language plays very important role in non-verbal communication. Now let's know more on about non-verbal communication. See, audio and video or visual signals also. In audio signals, examples, ring of telephone, calling bell, siren, buzzer. These are the audio signals. If your cell phone is ringing, then usually you can convey that somebody is calling you. If the doorbell is ring, then you can be identified that the particular person must be there on the door. Siren we get sometimes on from police siren or ambulance siren, even the buzzer that we use. This is a part of audio signals. This is a part of non-verbal communication. In visual signals, on the other hand, traffic signals that we see the red light, then we have to stop, and there is a green light, we have to run or we have to go. Other side, railway signals, that is also we see. If there is a green signal, that we can identify our train can go, train is ready to go. Signs printed on, some signs also printed, particularly this. We are having 3-4 tigers, lions picture, if you see, that is a sign of government of India. Cartoons, stripes at zebra crossing, that also we see for a pedestrian, that zebra crossing is there to walk on the street. So without having a word, that can be conveyed easily. So there are audio signals and there are visual signals also there. Now the gestures. I really appreciate the gestures, because when you are educated, when you are having something to show, your gesture must be perfect. How you stand, how you bow down, how you talk to people, how you are using your body language. Every content is included in gestures content. Let's see. Fidgeting shows boredom and restlessness. This is also a sign. Pressing fingers together to form steeple shows interest, assertiveness and determination. Touching the nose or rubbing eyes indicates discomfort. When you are discomfort, you do one thing, you are touching the nose or rubbing the eyes. This is gesture. A hand to the back of the neck may be indicate withdrawal from conversation. You are tired. Let's see this particular slide. I think easily you will understand, because this shows so many things without I am saying anything to you. Example of gestures in magic words. Please, the left side boy says please because he's putting hand. Second one is thank you, and third one is sorry. So through his three pictures, he has given a message through his gesture. Posture and body orientation. Posture, how you erect, how you stand. Posture and body orientation. In this particular slide, we're trying to know more on this. You communicate numerous messages by the way you talk and move. Standing erect and leaning forward communicates that you are approachable, receptive, and friendly. Interpersonal closeness results when you and your audience face each other. Speaking with your back turned or looking at the floor or ceiling should be avoided, as communicates disinterest. Posture and body orientation. We are trying to know more on body orientation part. Let's see. People can read your emotions through posture. See, people, this is very interesting line. I think we all should give emphasis on this. People can read your emotions through posture, how you stand, how you sit, through your body orientation. Someone who has excellent posture is also thought to have excellent power. When you sit, if your back is erect, that shows you are confident. You are having 100% focus on particular thing that you are listening. So your body orientation shows your particular emotions. Those who walk quickly and freely may be goal oriented. See, a person who is walking quickly and freely, that shows he is goal oriented. He is going somewhere to get that thing. While those who walk with their heads down and hands in their pocket may not be so motivated. You can see there are different people we see around us in our society. Someone you might have seen, someone is walking too quickly and freely also. That time we can identify at least that person is going to do his work, is trying to complete his task, his goal oriented guy. The other hand, someone who walks with their heads down like this and hands in their pocket may not be so motivated. Sometimes it shows that person is suffering from stress. Now the posture and body orientation, we are going to show you some facial expression that convey a message a lot. It's a part of non-verbal communication. First picture, anger. See how he looks, anger like that. Joy, he's happy because of his face like that. He's giving a message that I'm happy, I'm good, I'm happy like that. Surprise, he got shocked. Surprise, he come to know about his results. Oh my god, surprise. So his expression has been changed. Disgust, you are not convinced by the things told by someone else. That is disgusting. So you are showing disgust. Sad, you are sad. Suppose you are sad, you are unhappy, you are not happy. So that having a different picture. And suppose you are having a fear of something, fear of result, or fear of anything, that time your facial expression is different. So ultimately, the thing which I want to convey you, your facial expression plays very important role in non-verbal communication. If you are not even saying a word, you are not uttering a single word, you use your facial expression and you are trying to convey your message. Attire means your dress, how you look, that also convey through your attire properly, through your uniform. Suppose you are coming to the college with proper uniform, we can identify this is our student from our college. And sometimes you are coming with the civil dress also, that time also it will be little bit difficult for all of us to identify whether you are belong to our college if I don't know. So let's check these points also. Attire or dress is another important aspect of non-verbal communication. The way a person dresses is often subjected to much interpretation. Attire proclaims a person. As I said just now, because you are coming in the uniform, it will be easy for all of us to identify this particular boy as belong to our college. Appropriateness for the occasion is essential. The formality of the occasion, the time of the day, the season, the cultural background of the people who will be present, and the conventions of your own organization should provide good guidance. Informal or casual dressing conveys different meanings. Sometimes you are having a different attire at home, you are having uniform at office, when you are going for a particular function or party, that time you are having a different kind of attire, that conveys a different thing. So you can easily identify it without saying a word. Important and ceremonial occasions normally call for formal dress. At the other hand, organizations mostly have their dress codes. Now it's a bit comparison between verbal communication and non-verbal communication. See the first point in verbal communication. It means transmission of meaning through oral or written words. In non-verbal communication, the communication that takes place between sender and receiver with the use of sign or body language. Second point, it is based on face-to-face, phone or teleconferencing. The other hand, in non-verbal communication, it is based on facial expression, eye contact, smile, etc. Third point, short or long-term period. In non-verbal communication, it will be short-term period only, all the time. It is both formal and informal way of communication. In non-verbal communication, it is the verbal way of communication. It builds up human relations in verbal communication with the help of using words or oral communication. The other hand, in non-verbal communication, doesn't build up individual relations. Verbal communication affected up to 35% and non-verbal communication affected up to 65%. See these pictures. In this complete picture, you can get that verbal communication part and the percentage is 35% and non-verbal is 65%. Why 65%? See the point. The first one is facial expressions, tone of voice, movement, appearance, eye contact, gesture and postures. Just because of this all contents, this percentage of non-verbal is greater than verbal. Part B, oral and written communication. Oral communication, it is the process of verbally transmitting information and ideas from one individual group to another. Oral communication can be either formal or informal. Informal oral communication include face-to-face conversation, telephonic conversation, even discussion that take place at business meetings. Formal oral communication include presentation at business meeting, classroom lecture, commencement speeches given at the graduation ceremony. In oral communication, spoken words are used. It includes face-to-face conversation, it includes speech, telephonic conversation, video, radio, television, voice over internet, etc. In written communication, it means the sending a message ordered to instructions of writing through letters, circulars, manuals, reports, telegrams, office memos and bulletins, etc. In oral communication, we use spoken words, routine message, meeting, speech or telephone. On the other hand, written communication, we write the word, we form a type of communication and generally we use a letter, memo, emails, etc. What is the advantage of oral communication that we discuss within 5 minutes? The first point is save time. It saves your time. It is economical. It is immediate feedback. It gives immediate feedback to you. Save paperwork. It removes our doubts. Best tool during emergency. Disadvantage also we should discuss some oral communication. Not disadvantage we can say, but these are the low factor that we also give attention towards it. Misunderstanding, ineffective for lengthy communication, time consume, low retention rate, no legal validity, difficult to fix responsibility. The other hand, advantage of written communication. We are trying to know more on written communication. First, we'll see advantages. The first point is, it is precise and accurate, easily verified, it is permanent record, it has a permanent record, legal validity, responsibility fixes, and suitable for long time. So that all for today's lecture. I have explained everything about the non-verbal communication, its types, oral and written communication also. We have learned a lot about this. This is the part of unit number 1. If you still you are having queries about it, you can personal message to me. I request to all my dear students to subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon. Thank you so much for patience listening.